Hey everyone, I'm coming to you with another LakeGo Fact Check. Earlier this year, former Hendry County Commissioner Janet Taylor, who was a commissioner when LORS was put into place, setting the current levels that say 10.5 feet at the beginning of hurricane season is okay, had this to say about Martin County's algae-driven public health crisis.
We sympathize with you with the problems you have, but your problems is just as, our problems are greater than yours because our problem is people.
Our problems are greater than your problems because our problems are people. The fact is that we have something in common, and it's sad she and so many others do not see it. Both of our problems are people problems, and both are a result of Lake Okeechobee being too high. In Hendry County, their lives are at risk when too much water is on the lake because the dike can fail, flooding their community and killing people. In Martin County, our lives are at risk when too much water is on the lake and we have to take billions of gallons of often toxic water, not to protect our community, but to protect their community. Just last week, the EPA set a standard of 8 parts per billion microcystin, what's in blue-green algae, as being too toxic for human contact. That includes too toxic to swim in, too toxic to fish in, too toxic to boat in, too toxic to breathe the hazards that are coming off that water. Last summer, we received discharges containing toxic microcystin at the level of 495 parts per billion. That's more than 50 times too toxic for human contact. The cyanobacteria is known to cause vomiting, liver disease, Alzheimer's. Not only is this a people problem for both counties, it's a massive man-made human health crisis. The risk to both communities is significantly less when Lake Okeechobee is lowered before hurricane season, as we have successfully done this year. That is a LakeGo Fact Check.